When other people talk about where they came from and who they are and what their history is, that's called patriotism. But when black people do it, we're labeled as militant, rebels, Afrocentric. That's the big difference. Our history is offensive to people. So we have to stop being afraid and tell our own stories. So I'll be first. If the melanin in the skin is such a great defense, we can't pretend they intend to defend their rights. Black men sacrifice every night. In these streets we kill veterans, all because of melanin. George Zimmerman killed Trayvon and won. Now it's come down to one we've learned we must turn from.
It's terrible, you know, about just where math came from. You know, all of the pictures that they've shown out of Africa, they've never really educated the American, white or black, about what really goes on in Africa, what some of the cities are really like, and that we're not running around over there with Tarzan, you know. And when they show anything from Africa, even down to today, they pick the worst scenes, the most terrible situations, you know, and they show those. But we have a proud history. But of course, what we did in Egypt 5,000 years ago, or what we did in China 35,000 years ago, is of no benefit if we don't understand what to do today and how that would help us to survive.
If the melanin in the skin is such a great defense, we can't pretend they intend to defend their rights. Black men sacrifice every night. In these streets we kill veterans, all because of melanin. George Zimmerman killed Trayvon and won. Now it's come down to one we've learned we must turn from. If the melanin in the skin is such a great defense, we can't pretend they intend to defend their rights. Black men sacrifice every night. In these streets we kill veterans, all because of melanin. George Zimmerman killed Trayvon and won. Now it's come down to one we've learned we must turn from.
Blue, black, Jesus. 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 Blue, black, Jesus.
We have the Monomotapan Empire in what today we call Zimbabwe. There are over 300 stone structures in southern Africa. And then you have that great structure in the great Zimbabwe that shows a direct relationship to the Grand Lodge of Luxor in Egypt. You have Pouanit, which is in today's Somalia, Ethiopia. You have the Kush empires that are simultaneously happening. When Hatshepsut, the great pharaoh king, although she was a woman, she was a pharaoh king, sitting on the throne of Kemet, her cousin sits on the throne of Pouanit, or what we call Somalia. There are great things happening historically across the African continent. You have the kingdoms of Kuba and Luba in Central Africa.
If the melanin in the skin is such a great defense, we can't pretend they intend to defend their rights. Black men sacrifice every night. In these streets we kill veterans, all because of melanin. George Zimmerman killed Trayvon and won. Now it's come down to one we've learned we must turn from. If the melanin in the skin is such a great defense, we can't pretend they intend to defend their rights. Black men sacrifice every night. In these streets we kill veterans, all because of melanin. George Zimmerman killed Trayvon and won. Now it's come down to one we've learned we must turn from.
Blue, black, Jesus. 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 Blue, black, Jesus.
If the melanin in the skin is such a great defense, we can't pretend they intend to defend their rights. Black men sacrifice every night. In these streets we kill veterans, all because of melanin, Drazama men. Kill Trayvon and one, now it's come down to one we've learned we must turn from.
People always ask me, why do the black church not get rid of the white Jesus and put a blue black Jesus in place with a nappy head? People always ask me, why do the black church not get rid of the white Jesus and put a blue black Jesus in place with a nappy head? Because black people would stop going. 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 Because black people would stop going.